Hello everyone! Today I'd like to show you how to crochet a woman's long sleeve sweater. For the project, I use a down tab technique both for the body and sleeves and crochet them in the round. Hope you like the design and style of the pullover and consider making one for yourself. I'll start with the ribbon, and for the ribbon I already made the foundation chain of 11 chain stitches. And for the first row, I will work single crochet. For that, I will insert my hook into the second chain from my hook, grab the yarn and pull it through. I have 2 stitches on my hook, grab the yarn and pull it through. So one single crochet in the following chain, second single crochet, and work single crochet to end of the row. At the end of the first row, work one returning chain and turn. Then I will work single crochet using just back loops. So I will work back loop single crochet. This is my front loops and those are my back loops. So in the second chain, back loop single crochet, and again back loop single crochet, and so on to end of the row. At the end of my second row, work one returning chain and turn. My third row and all the rest rows I will work like second row. So I will insert my hook into the second chain from my hook and work back loop single crochet. So I will work back loop single crochet to end. And at the end, I will work one returning chain. And then I will just continue back loop single crochet rows until I crochet 120 rows in total. After you crochet 120 rows of the ribbon, just join very last row with very first one, match closely chains, insert the hook into the very first chain . Grab the yarn and pull it through those 2 chains, then insert the hook, skip this chain and insert the hook into the following chain and in the next chain on this side, grab the yarn and pull it through these 3 chains and then just continue that way to end of the row. At the end of the row, continue joining the ribbon. And then flip the garment to the wrong side in order to hide the seam. Here is my ribbon and here is my rows. And one rib is 2 rows. So I will pick one chain on each row of the ribbon and increase one chain every 6 rows or 3 ribs. So single crochet, one, so it's one chain on one row, then this is second row, chain here, so again single crochet, one here, so again next row, one more single crochet, next row, single crochet, and one more single crochet. So 1, 2, 3 ribs, it means I work 6 single crochet. Now I will work extra chain, so I will increase, and then I will continue just one chain in one row for my next 6 rows, and then I will work one increase again. So at the end I should have 140 chains in total, so not 120 but 140 because of the increase every 6 rows. At the end of the round, count again how many stitches you have, and if 140, just work one slip stitch. Then continue single crochet for 20 rounds as usual in the next chain. After you work 20 rounds of single crochet, just work one slip stitch. And then just continue the pattern. Work one chain, skip one chain, and work bump. For that, work single crochet, three chains, and again single crochet in the same chain. So this one bump, then 2 chains, skip 2, 1, 2, and work again second bump. Again single crochet, 3 chains, and again single crochet in the same chain. So this is second bump, again 2 chains, skip 2, and again bump, single crochet, chain 3, single crochet. So I will continue bump, chain 2, skip 2, bump, chain 2, skip 2 to end of my round. At the end of the round, when you have just 2 chains left, so work 2 chains, skip those 2 chains, and in this chain, in the 3rd chain, work 1 bump again. So single crochet, 3 chains, and again single crochet in the same chain. So now work 2 chains again, skip bump, and skip this first chain after the bump, and work in the second chain 1 bump again. then again 2 chains, and again skip 1 bump, skip the first chain after the bump, and work 1 bump in the second chain. So I will continue the process to end of my round, and I will work all the rest rounds like my second round. At the end of the second round, after the bump, work 2 chains, then skip 1 bump, 1 chain, and work 1 bump . So here I started my round, and then for the third round just work, continue 2 chains, skip 1 bump, skip 1 chain, and just work following bump and so on to end of the round. That's what you should get so far. And I will continue the pattern until I crochet 12 rounds in total. After you work 12 rounds of the pattern, work another 20 rounds of single crochet. For that, for the first round, I will work 1 chain above each bump and just work 2 single crochet. Then again 1 chain above the bump, and then again 2 single crochet, and so on to end of the round, and then a regular 19 single crochet rounds. So again 1 chain and so on. So that's what you should have so far. Here's my ribbon, 20 single crochet rounds, 12 rounds of the raspberry pattern, and again 20 single crochet rounds. So now I will work 1 slip stitch and continue raspberry pattern a little bit differently, because I will not crochet in the round anymore. I will work rows right and wrong side. So I will work 2 chains in the following chain, and also I will work half of my chains, so I will work 70 chains. And in the following chain I will work bump, so single crochet, 3 chains as usual, and again single crochet in the same chain, so 1 bump, and then 1 loose chain, just regular chain but do it loosely, skip 2 and again bump. And that way I will continue to end of my row. So 1 bump, loose chain, skip 2, and then again bump. For the first row, I worked 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22 bumps. Then I will work 1 loose chain, skip 2, and work 1 single crochet. We'll work 2 returning chains and turn. Second row, I will insert my hook into the 4th chain from my hook, 1, 2, 3, 4, and we'll work bump. Again, 1 loose chain, and then I will insert my hook into the chain between 2 bumps. And work again 1 bump. And then I will just continue loose chain and then bump between 2 bumps of the previous row. So I will continue that way to end of my row. And all my rest rows will be like my second row. At the end of my second row, after last bump, work 1 loose chain as usual, skip 1 bump and work 1 single crochet in the very last chain of the row, then work 2 chains and turn. My third row will be like my second one, so I will insert my hook into the 4th chain from my hook, 1, 2, 3, 4, and work bump. Loose chain, and then again I will insert my hook into the chain between 2 bumps and that way I will continue to end of my row, my third row, and then all the rest rows will be also like my second row. After you crochet 12 rows of the pattern, just continue single crochet. Work 1 chain, 1 single crochet. Then above each bump 2 chains. And again 1 single crochet in between those bumps. And then that way I will continue to end of my row, again 2 chains above 1 bump and then again 1 single crochet and so on to end of my row. After my last single crochet I will work again 2 chains as usual, skip 1 bump and work single crochet in the very last chain of the row, then work 1 chain, 1 returning chain and turn. Then it's my front side. For my second row, in order to keep single crochet pattern, I will work single crochet backwards, just from the right side, insert the hook into a second chain from your hook, grab the yarn and pull it through. Then just grab the yarn and pull it through those two chains. So that way I will continue to end of my row. When I finish my single crochet backwards row, my second row, I worked one returning chain, and here I start to work my shoulder piece. So for that I work 16 chains, just 16 single crochet, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, and again I will work one returning chain and turn. And then again on the front side I will work single crochet backwards. So I will insert my hook from the right side of the garment, pull the yarn through, and then pull the yarn through the two chains on your hook. So that way I will continue to end of my row, and then we'll work one returning chain, and then I will just alternate single crochet row on the right side and then single crochet backwards row on the front side. After you finish your front part with two shoulder pieces, attach the yarn and work the pattern for 12 rows as you did for the front part, and then instead of just two rows work 12 rows. So on the front side I work single crochet backwards plus one returning chain, and on the right side I work single crochet to end plus one returning chain. And then for the first back shoulder piece I work just four rows, totally the same on 16 chains like here, just smaller, and totally the same second back shoulder piece, also four rows, and on the front side I work single crochet backwards plus one returning chain, and on the right side I work single crochet to end plus one returning chain. And now I will show you how to join my two shoulder pieces together. To join two shoulder pieces together, I will put my right side of my back piece and right side of my front piece, shoulder piece together. And my front side is facing to me, and it's also front side. Then I will match closely my chains. And then just insert the hook into the very last chain, grab the yarn and pull it through. Then I will insert my hook into the back loop on my one side and front loop on the other side, on the other shoulder piece. Grab the yarn and pull it through. Then again in the following two chains, back loop and front loop, grab the yarn and pull it through. So that way I will continue to end of my row. I worked sleeve similar to my body, so I made the ribbon like here, but instead of 120 rows I worked 30 rows and then joined the very last row with very first one to continue crocheting in the round. and I also increased one chain every six rows or three ribbon, and after my first row I had 35 chains. So I worked those 35 chains for 20 rounds and then continue the pattern for 12 rounds, totally the same like I did here, and then I increased 3 chains. So I increased from 35 to 38 chains and I worked those 38 chains for 20 rounds, so this is single crochet rounds, and then I continued again 12 rounds of the pattern, and here I increased one chain every round. So I work 11 rounds and I increased 11 chains. So now I'll show you how to join the sleeve to the garment, and also after my 11 chains increase from 38 plus 11, I should have 49 chains. I flip my sleeve to the front side, and I'm already on the front side here, and I will start from the bottom. So I will insert my hook into a chain at the bottom of my sleeve, and in this last chain and pull it through, and then I will work similar as I join my shoulder pieces together. I will insert my hook on one side in one chain and on the other side, and on this side, on the side of the sleeve, I will work through my front loops. Then grab the yarn and pull it through. Then again in a chain here and in a front loop on this, on the sleeve side, and again pull the yarn through the three chains on your hook. So that way I will work all the way around my sleeve. At the end I have more chains on this side than on the sleeve side, so I will cover the whole, like inserting one chain, then in the following, so on into, I inserted in two chains on this side and just in one on the other side, and pull the yarn through, then again do the same thing. And still whole, just cover it. Make sure that there is no hole, and then just cut the yarn and secure it. After you attach the sleeve, that's what you should get so far. And now I will work around the neck. For that, with a smaller hook, I will work just single crochet tightly. At the end of the round, work one slip stitch, then cut the yarn and secure it. For the neck ribbon, like for my sleeve ribbon, I also work 11 chain stitches with the foundation chain and worked 100 rows. Then I joined the very last row with the very first one and started to join this ribbon to the garment. And I did it totally the same as I joined my two shoulder pieces together and my sleeve to the garment. So for that, I will show you. Insert a hook in one chain on the ribbon side, and then on the other side, grab the yarn and pull it through. So that way I will finish joining my ribbon, neck ribbon. So like so, cover all the hole to end. After you finish joining the neck ribbon, the sweater is ready, and thank you for watching.